Good morning, all of you. So from today onwards, I'm going to take your computer applications class. So I came to know that you have completed two chapters. Now, third chapter I'm going to start with. Before that, I just want to talk to you people about how you people are feeling at home. Since it's more than 1 month, you all are there at home and continuous videos are being given by the teachers so that you can study at home also. At this time, I want to give some suggestions to you people that don't think about what is going to be happening in future. Just concentrate what is going on presently. Okay, don't think how our exams will be conducted, how we are going to complete the syllabus, blah, blah, blah. You don't have to think about those things. Okay, only you need to exercise daily, use mask, keep on washing your hands, and remember, together we can beat COVID-19. Stay home, break the chain. So follow the instructions given by local authorities. That way only we can get success. So let's start with today's chapter, that is types of software. And don't forget, this is the time to find calm in all these chaos.
So let's start with the chapter, types of software. So before starting the different types of software, I want to make you understand that basically a computer consists of two parts, hardware and software. Now, the basic thing you need to understand the difference between these two. If I'll ask you that whatever displayed on the screen, can you hold it in your hand? No, you cannot. But if it is getting printed on a paper, that time can you hold it in your hand? Yes. Answer will be yes. So the things which you can see but you cannot touch are known as software. Okay, and the parts of the computer which you can see, you can move it from one place to another, you can hold it in your hand, are known as hardware. Then hardware, as I told, the proper definition you just see from here, hardware is basically represents the physical and tangible components of the computer that the components can be seen and touched. Examples are input and output devices. In the previous chapter, you must have learnt about input and output devices. Input are the devices which used to feed the instructions to the computer, and then output devices which helps you to take the output from the computer. Then CPU, floppy disk, hard disk, these all things you can see, touch. Okay, these are the tangible components of the computer and these are known as hardware. Here with the help of this diagram also I have tried to explain. Have you seen the RAM card? Inside CPU it is there, you can hold it in your hand. Then we have mouse, keyboard, printer, hard disk and CPU. So these are the examples of hardware. Next comes software. Your computer, when you're working with your system, you are instructing, you're clicking on the screen and according to your means click or any other key pressing event, your system responds. So what happens that these are the way of giving instructions to the computer. So these instructions, computer will not understand your language. These instructions are given to the computer in zeros and ones only. Those instructions, those programs which helps to govern the operation of your computer system and that will make your hardware to run. Without software, your computer will not run. You are having a box, okay, which looks like a computer, but if you don't have the software, it won't run. So hardware is there, but without software, your system cannot run. Means the instructions which will help you to make your system understand what things the user wants to do, so those things will make, means the computer can understand with the help of software only. Then we have the types of software. See, basically on the usage, means how these softwares are used, basically there are two categories of software. First is system software and second one is application software. Now just concentrate on this diagram. If I give you, means a desktop which is having a monitor, a CPU, keyboard, mouse, printer, all the required things are available. Okay, but you don't have any software in it. So, will it run? No. So, the softwares, basic softwares which are required to run your computer are known as system software. Can you give me one example of system software? Yes, try. It's operating system. If you run your system, you are having a laptop, you have pressed the power button on, and your system is not having operating system. Will it run? No. So, operating system is a type of software which makes your hardware to run, your computer to run. Running, it's not that running, means to operate. Okay. So, the softwares which are required for smooth functioning of your computer, without which your system or your hardware cannot do anything, are known as system software. So, one of the example I've already given you, which is the basic example of system software. Next comes, how user will use it. Like, only system software is installed in the computer and I want a presentation to be made. Will I be able to make with system software? No. So, according to my requirement, I'll install few application softwares on the computer which I'll be using. Like, for making presentation, I'll be installing PowerPoint. For typing a letter, I'll be installing Microsoft Word. Means a package of softwares, application packages I will be installing. So, those softwares which are having a specific purpose, without which also a computer will work, but for some specific purposes those softwares are used, are known as application softwares. Okay, so basically the user uses your hardware with the help of application softwares, and these application softwares are installed on the computer with the help of these system software. What makes your hardware to run? System software. What makes your application software to install? Here, system software. What makes user to work with the computer? Application software. Understood? So basically, how many categories of software are there? Two types: system software and application software. Next comes, what is a system software? I have already explained, but the proper definition which you will require to write in your computer corpus, do follow all the slides and write the proper definition from these slides only. If you don't have a book, you can use these slides as means for writing the instruction part and all, or you can follow these slides, or if you have the book, write it from there. A computer basically works according to the instructions given to it. These instructions are provided through software to it. Okay, the software which controls internal computer operations are known as, or is known as, system software. Internal operations, you understand, like I'm typing something from the keyboard, but we know that your computer understands only zeros and ones. I'm typing capital A. Internally, it gets converted to zeros and ones, which your computer understands. So, the softwares which are responsible for doing this internal operations are known as system software. Next, types of system software. Basically, there are three types of system software. One is operating system. Second one is language processors. Third one, utilities or utility software. So, that's all for today's class. In the next class, I'll explain all these categories and their examples as well. So, for the time being, just go through all the slides and try to write the answers given in the assignment attached with this video through Campus Care. I have sent it to you. So, any doubts if you have, try to clear out those doubts with Campus Care. You can message me through Campus Care. I'll try to send the answers whenever I'll get time, and do write all the answers given in the assignment part. Very few questions are there because only one topic I have completed. Okay, thank you.